हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम प्रोफेसर बनकर डीबी, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, आरबीएनबी कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर. इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी हैव सीन द रिएक्शन ऑफ ग्लूकोज ऑकरिंग इनसाइड द सॉइल. एज वी नो दैट इन द सॉइल डिफरेंट रिएक्शन कैन बी ऑकरिंग इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म और समटाइम इन प्रेजेंस ऑफ डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मिनरल्स और वी कैन से सम रिएजेंट. इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल सी सम मोर रिएक्शन दैट आर ऑकरिंग इन द सॉइल. कंसिडर नेक्स्ट रिएक्शन. In soil, such type of amino acid molecules are present. That amino acid molecule react with water. There is formation of initially alcohol. There is formation of alcohol plus there is liberation of carbon, sorry, there is liberation of ammonia as well as CO2 gas. This ammonia can react with water. This ammonia can react with water. There is formation of ammonium carbonate. There is formation of ammonium carbonate. This ammonium carbonate can further react with oxygen and there is formation of nitrous acid. Plus there is also evolution of water molecule. So this process of conversion of amino acid into ammonia, this process of conversion of amino acid into ammonia is called as ammonification. The process in which there is conversion of amino acid into ammonia is called as ammonification. Then we have different types of processes, but that processes are not much useful in the soil. Then we will see the next point. Next point is soil atmosphere. This soil atmosphere include soil gases or we can say air. So this soil gases or air is one of the component of the soil. As we know that soil has different components, so this soil gases or air is one of the component of the soil. So in soil there is presence of soil particle as well as different types of gases. We have one circle. That circle can indicate the presence of composition of the specific loamy soil. So this is 45% of mineral matter. Five % organic matter, 25% air,
and 25% water. So this figure indicate approximate composition of loamy surface soil.
So this is approximate composition of loamy surface soil figure. So this figure indicate that this loamy surface soil consists of 45% mineral matter, only 5% organic matter, 25% air and 25% water. This figure clearly indicate that the soil consists of major proportion of mineral matter, minor proportion of organic matter, and there is also presence of air and water. So there is presence of small amount of organic matter, but that organic matter is one of the most important component of the soil, and that organic matter make the soil fertile. Next point is soil aeration. If in the soil there is proper circulation of the air, or we can say if in the soil there is proper movement of gases from one layer to the other layer, then that soil becomes more fertile, and in that soil plant perform their activities in good ratio, and that plant becomes good for good development of the crop. So this soil aeration means there is circulation of the gases, circulation of the air from one layer to the other layer, and that soil becomes good for the agriculture purpose. So this soil consists of different types of gases. That gases include nitrogen, oxygen, CO2. Soil basically include nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide. Along with this, that soil consists of water vapors. If the circulation of this type of component in the soil is good, then that soil is fertile in nature. Next point is soil water. Soil absorb water, and that absorption ratio is depends on the amount of water in the given soil. If in the given soil there is huge amount of water, then that plant absorb water, and if the soil consists of less amount of water, then that plant does not absorb proper amount of water. So this water is essential. That water perform different important processes inside the plant. So this water is basically necessary for photosynthesis. Water is basically necessary for photosynthesis and to perform metabolic processes. This water act as carrier of food nutrient. Water act as carrier for food nutrient. It means that water can carry different types of important nutrient present in the soil. That nutrients are carried from one place to the other place. So this is one of the important role of the water for the plant. Soil obtain water from rain. Soil obtain water from rain, from snow, from dew, or also from irrigation. So these are different sources through which that soil can absorb the water, that is rain, snow, dew, and also irrigation. So by this different ways that soil take the water. Soil water is divided into different forms. Soil water is divided as hygroscopic water, this is water absorbed by the dry soil, then second is capillary water, then third gravitational water. So basically these are the three types of soil water: hygroscopic water, capillary water, and gravitational water. The next important component of the soil is soil microorganisms. Soil consists of different types of microorganism, and that microorganism include one of the important component of the soil. We can say biological system. So in the soil different types of microorganisms are present, and that microorganism include algae, fungi, bacteria, different types of protozoa, etc. So these type of microorganisms are present in the soil. Each and every microorganism is essential for the plant growth, and that microorganism perform different processes, different functions inside the soil, and that functions, processes ultimately affect the growth of the plant. Each and every microorganism is responsible for specific change. Each and every microorganism is responsible for specific change or transformation in the soil, or transformation in the soil. This type of microorganism synthesizes large number of microbial tissues. Microbial tissues and cells. This type of microorganism synthesizes different types of microbial tissues and cells, and that microbial tissues and cell act as a organic matter. Act as a organic matter, and this organic matter then convert into the fertilizer. That organic matter consists of essential nutrients that are required for the plant. So this is also one of the important function of the microorganism, that is there is development of organic matter in the form of tissues and cells. The activity of such type of microorganism is affected by moisture in the soil, then temperature, then light, that is sunlight, then different types of reactions in the soil, then air, then availability of food in the soil, then energy supply, like that. So the activity of microorganism can be affected by moisture, temperature, light, reaction, air, food and energy supply. If this type of parameters are present in excess or present in less quantity, then that microorganism cannot survive in the soil atmosphere. It means that this type of parameter should be present in optimum amount. Optimum amount. If that parameters are in optimum amount, then that microorganism perform their activity in well manner, that will be beneficial to the growing plants. The main function of that microorganism is to help plant, that is to provide different types of essential nutrients. The next point is physical properties of soil. Physical properties of soil. Physical properties of soil. In that we will see soil horizon. During the formation of soil, there is development of different types of layers. During the formation of soil, there is development of different types of layers, and that layers are called as soil horizon. So soil horizon are nothing but different types of layers that will generate during the formation of soil. So that soil horizon are of three types. First is A horizon. So this is upper horizon, or we can say upper layer. It is also called as top soil. So this upper horizon is most developed layer. Then second is B horizon. This is also upper layer. That layer present below the A horizon. This is called as subsoil. And next is C horizon. This is lowest horizon. And that C horizon is not much well developed. So depending on the presence of this layer, that classified as A horizon, B horizon and C horizon. In this lecture, I will stop here. In next lecture, we will see the remaining part of this particular topic. Thank you.